I believe I can touch the sky. Hello, I'm Liam Higgins, and welcome to Cinematic Soundtracks. Now, today is my 20th birthday. That's right, I am no longer a teenager. Sure, 21 is seen as a better year, considering you get more freedom, but still, it's pretty cool that I'm no longer a teenager. Now, to celebrate my 20th birthday, I'm going to do two reviews for you, What is Love by Haddaway and Hito Shizuku by Zone. Also, I'm going to set a new rule for cinematic soundtracks. Now, beforehand, I would only review music videos for songs that were written for the movie or songs that were used to promote the movie. But now, not only am I going to review that, but I am also going to review songs that are considered the theme song for the movie but weren't actually written for the movie or used to promote the movie when it first came out. The reason I'm going to do this is because there are many songs out there that I thought had interesting music videos that are considered theme songs for movies that I feel I should talk about. Now, the first one I'm going to review is What is Love by Haddaway.
What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me no more.
In 1993, Haddaway came out with What is Love, which was a big hit when it first came out as it reached number 11 on the US Billboard charts. However, it kind of faded into obscurity until it started being heard in SNL's Roxbury skits, plus the movie Based on said skits, and now it is a very popular song, being featured in YTMND and many commercials and YouTube poops. With a song this popular, it must have a great music video, right? Let's just look at What is Love by Haddaway. So our music video begins with Haddaway flipping a statue in the air and pretending to hit on it. Dude, you need to get laid. Oh, and yes, this video is filmed with gauzy lenses, which, as you know, I just love. The movie, on the other hand, had this gauzy haze, soft focus, and bad lighting, not to mention the Dutch angles. So Haddaway runs throughout the mansion while three ladies dance and a Viking lady just stands there. As it turns out, Haddaway is attracted to the Viking lady. Why is the love interest a Viking lady? Seriously, what's the point of the costume? Then the girls dance while lights keep flashing and they keep having uncomfortable close-ups of them to the point where you can't see anything and the camera keeps rushing around. Why film it like this? I mean, it makes the video an eyesore to look at because this style of filming is hard to watch. How would you like it if I filmed my show this way? Hello, I'm Liam Higgins and welcome to Cinematic Soundtracks. Not to mention, because they're filming it like this, sometimes they do close-ups of things that don't need close-ups like a statue. I don't think I need to say this again, but keep the camera still, director. Your video is already visually repugnant. Then Haddaway pursues the blonde dancer. Wait, I thought he was into the Viking lady. Oh, whatever. Then we cut to a puff of smoke. For no reason. Does anything in this video have a reason? Now, I have to say, I like how bored Haddaway looks.
I don't know, but you're not there.
People say I lack facial expressions. Compared to this guy, I'm Jim Carrey. So after seeing to the Viking lady, he disappears just by waving his arms up in the air. I wonder if that would work. Then the Viking lady is about to bite into him. Apparently, she's a Viking vampire lady. That actually sounds pretty awesome. Kind of out of place in the video, though. Then Haddaway changes his clothes just by producing a bolt of lightning by waving his arms. You've got the power to produce lightning and you just use it to change your clothes? Lame. Then, as they're dancing, we keep getting uncomfortable close-ups of the dancers and other random things, and Haddaway alternates between hitting on the Viking vampire lady and the blonde. Okay, who is your love interest, Haddaway? I mean, what is the point of having two love interests? Pick one and stick with it! Also, while this is happening, we get unnecessary shots of the corridor and Haddaway looking bored while dressed in a blue tux. I know I sound like a broken record, but what is the point of cutting to these things? Then, as they're dancing, the Viking vampire leaves because I guess she learned he cheated on him. How she learned that is never explained because it's not made clear whether she was there the same time as a blonde, and Haddaway decides to give her flowers, then they get together and the Viking vampire lady has a random crotch shot. Apparently, the director is a heterosexual version of Joel Schumacher. Then we get more dancing, terrible camera work, and lights. So that was Haddaway's video for What Is Love, and what an obnoxious video! Seriously, talk about an eyesore. The camera can't keep still and keeps cutting annoying close-ups, which makes it hard to watch. It doesn't help that there are lights blinking on and off and it's filmed in a gauzy haze. The direction wasn't bad enough. They keep having close-ups of things that have nothing to do with anything. Plus, Haddaway looks bored and the story is poorly handled. If they were trying to go for Haddaway trying to choose between the blonde and the Viking vampire lady, they could have made that more clear. Also, what is the point of making the love interest a Viking vampire lady? If you're going to have a ridiculous costume, make sure it fits with the story you're trying to tell. Let's just hope that Hiroshi Zuku is better.